are you? Welcome again to my kitchen, and today it's seafood and wine. Cooking fish and wine, or having wine with fish. You know, it's impossible to think of an Italian, or a Greek for that matter, or a Frenchman having fish for dinner without a glass of wine. Fish and wine go together. As a matter of fact, biblically, do you remember, there's a story of Jesus appearing on the edge of the sea, and the first thing he said was, what do you have to eat? That was an argument against an old heresy called docetism, to say he was really present, really there, you see. And they had fried fish and a little wine. So this is the old fish luncheon that you find in the Gospels. The first thing I want to do today is to celebrate some squid in a cream sauce with ginger in it. And I stole this recipe. Let me get it started first. I stole this recipe from a restaurant in Seattle called Place Pigalle in the middle of the public market. I have half a cup in a saucepan, half a cup of chicken broth. I'm going to add half a cup of white wine and half a cup of a half and half, or you can use cream. I don't want to use cream. I'm just going to use half and half. This will be fine. We're going to reduce that now by about a third. Let that come to a simmer. You see, it's going to curdle. Don't worry about that. It almost turns to cheese, but it will, once it begins to simmer, it will come down. It will break down again. Now, while that's reducing, I'm going to show you how to clean squid. I know they're ugly, but please don't give up eating squid just because they look funny. Let's talk about the creature. Here he is. I love these. This is an awfully big one. These come frozen. You can buy these in any fish market in the country. See how long he is? This the tentacles at the front of him. Well, no, that's actually, this is his head, but he swims backwards. Did you know that? He goes through the water this way, not this way. And in order to clean him, you simply pull off the head, and all the innards will come right out with it. You see that? Comes right out, and then squeeze out what you missed. That is to say, gelatin that's in the center of the fish. Then you pull out the backbone, which is a most interesting piece of cuttle bone. And it looks like plastic. Isn't that fascinating? It looks like something DuPont would manufacture, but it isn't. And then you pull off the outer skin to make the fish nice and white-looking, see? Then rinse this off, and you cut him into rings. There, I'm not going to bother with the whole thing, but you cut him into rings because he is a tube now, you see? At least supposed to be a tube. There, it's a tube. So we'll cut these into rings, and that's what we're going to simmer in our sauce. Let me get rid of these big ones. I've already cleaned them and cut them up for you. And don't go yuck to me. Stop it. Squid is a wonderful food product. It's not at all expensive, and it's very versatile as long as you don't cook it too long. If you cook squid too long, it becomes tough as rubber. As a matter of fact, that's why some of you don't like to eat squid, because you're, oh, it's tough, it's tough. No, it's not tough. It's not tough at all. All right, that's doing fine. Let me add some more ingredients to our sauce. We've reduced this by a third. Actually, it hasn't gone down that far yet, but we're just going to do it anyhow. It's a wonderful dish. All right, now to this, we're going to add a bit of fresh ginger. And you remember, ginger, originally from the Orient, comes in a big hand. You buy a hand of ginger. Don't use dry ginger, use fresh ginger. And this is this tiny little washboard is a ginger grater. Now grate this into the sauce. We want about a half teaspoon of freshly grated ginger. This is what he does at Place Pigalle, or something like this. I've never asked him for the recipe, but I think I've come pretty close to what he does. All right, so we have half a cup of chicken stock, half a cup of dry white wine, half a cup of cream, or half and half. We've reduced that a bit. Then we added the ginger, about a half a teaspoon or a teaspoon if you like it a little rich. And now we'll add there. We'll add a roux. And remember, roux is simply flour. I've got to get a whipper here. Flour and butter blended together in a hot frying pan for a few minutes so that the flour gets rid of the raw flavor. And I want a tablespoon of flour and a tablespoon of butter. You see? From my pan, I've just melted this down and let it toast for just a second. Don't want it brown because you'll destroy the sauce in terms of its color. Stir that into the sauce. And the sauce is finished. Now we'll throw in the squid. It's very rare that you make a sauce and then cook the food in it. Normally we put the sauce over the top, but in this case, because we don't want to overcook the squid, we're going to put it right in now. Right into the sauce. The thing's finished. I don't know. Maybe I should put some salt and pepper in this, huh? Let me try it and see. Yes, it needs a little, just a tiny pinch of salt, itty bitty, and a little bit of pepper, and then the crowning blow. Daniel, will you get me some, Dijon mustard out of the refrigerator, please? I forgot it, please. There we go. The Dijon mustard, you can use Grey Poupon if you like, something like that, but it's a wonderful thing to have in the kitchen, and I was startled. Thank you, sir. I was startled when I first tasted this, because the mustard and the ginger are so foreign to our taste. fresh ginger, the white sauce, we made wine, chicken broth, and a little cream. And then we're going to stir in some Dijon mustard. I put in about a tablespoon. I almost forgot that on you. That's terrible, because that's what does it. The minute I tasted that, I realized something was wrong. Please do, in your own cooking, please keep lists for yourself when you're cooking for a dinner party or something. It's perfectly all right to have a list in the kitchen. Don't feel bad. That way you won't make mistakes when you're serving sherry and hugging your guests and all that. All right, we'll stir in a good pound of squid, maybe 2 pounds if you like. You're making a big pot full. You'll have enough sauce for that easily. There. And we'll cook that for just a few minutes here. Just until the squids, well, they'll curl up. It'll look like little donuts. I know that sounds absurd, but it's going to. There. We'll let those cook for a bit now, and when they're tender, looks like pasta, doesn't it? Looks like fettuccine of some sort. But it's not. All right. We'll put that aside, and I'll go on another dish, because I want to cook that for just a minute, and I'll come back to it. All right. Secondly, we're going to cook a salmon in green sauce, and this one is typical of Northwest cooking, my part of the country. First of all, you want to prepare a light sauce of olive oil and dill. Got a pan here and some green. Oh, I've got all kinds of good things for us today. Wonderful things. There it is. That's everything. I want to prepare a sauce of olive oil and some dill weed. Oh, a couple tablespoons of olive oil, 1/4 cup, something like that. Depends how much you're going to have. And some lemon juice. Remember how you cut up lemons? Cut them in half and then use a lemon reamer. Please don't use artificial lemon juice or reconstituted or whatever you want to call it. A couple tablespoons of lemon juice. And now we want 1/2 tablespoon of dill weed. Wonderful stuff. Dill, lemon juice, and olive oil is going to make a very nice, flavor on the top of our salmon. There, I have my broiler on in the oven, and I'm using salmon steaks. That's enough. See how that thickens up? There. Now let me get the salmon out here for you, and I'll show what I mean. The salmon steaks are all ready to go. And I'm going to brush them on both sides with the lemon juice, dill, and olive oil. This does two things. One, of course, it flavors the fish. But finally, it protects the fish from drying out when you put it under a broiler. Now brush these on both sides, then pop them under a broiler, and I don't think it's going to take more than about 5 minutes on a side if the steaks are really thick. And that should do it. I've already done a batch of these, but you understand what I'm saying, don't you? About 5 minutes on a side, then turn them over. And you may want to brush them again. That'd be fine with me. I have a whole bunch of them here ready to go. They're gorgeous. And now let's make the sauce for our salmon with green sauce. And the green sauce is going to look like chopped up lawn. And this is how it's made. Into our blender or food processor, we're going to put 2 tablespoons of yellow onions. Just chuck them right in there. And then we're going to add a green pepper, a sweet bell pepper. And all I want to do is just whack it up into a few pieces. Boy, this is a mess here today. More fun. You see that? Just cut it in half. Don't fiddle around trying to core these things, and then you take out the core. There's nothing to it. All righty? And then we'll throw it in the blender. Knock out the seeds. You don't want those. There we go. We're going to chop all of this up anyhow, so it doesn't really matter. And we want 2 bunches of spinach leaves. And I have, you know, I've already cleaned these. There's a lot of mud on spinach. Be careful. Be sure and get them out. No stems, just the leaves. There we go. That should be enough, I think. We have to pour a little water in this to get them to whip down. I don't know. We'll see what happens, huh? Sometimes water is necessary. We're going to whip that down now with a lid here. Whoops, got to go back to my squid. I don't want to overcook that. I think it's done. Matter of fact, I'm sure it's done. Let's see what happens here. They all turned into donuts yet? Well, not quite. Just another second here. I put an awful lot in a small pan, you see, so it'll take them another minute. Just one more second. Don't want to overdo these. It would be disastrous if we overcook squid. Let's see now. Here we go. We want to just chop this up. If you're a child, and don't you dare do this. Don't you put your hand in. You use a wooden spoon. There we go. Come on, cut down. There it goes. We're going to add some mayonnaise to this, too, and it'll make a lovely green sauce for our salmon. That's enough. There it goes. Just takes a second. You know, we don't want to chop it too long here. Okay, there. See what I've done? It's very, very thick and very, very delicious. What's the line from our crazy man, Thiek and Ilitch? The Billy Christie line? I love him. Put some in a bowl. I'm going to add a half cup of mayonnaise to this and some chopped green onions, all three perhaps. But I don't want the onions diced up too small, so I'm going to chop those by hand. They're right here, ready to go. Now remember, when you chop things, keep those fingers bent under. Keep them bent under thusly. So that you remember that? Oh, I tell you that all the time. Please remember. So important. That's enough. That will go into our sauce, into our green sauce, which now looks like chopped up lawn. If you kids want to call this fish under the grass, I don't care. You can call it anything you want. Where's some mayonnaise here? Here we are, right in front of me. Half a cup of mayonnaise, which will act, one is a binder. And the term binder means that it holds everything together. And two, it helps flavor the sauce. It lightens it a bit. Raw spinach over fish? Why not? I think we have everything. Let me taste this now and see. We need a little bit of lemon juice, and then we'll be set. All right, the lemon is right ready here. Where did I put my reamer? Well, I don't know what I did with my lemon. Here he is. A little bit of lemon juice, a couple tablespoons. There. We're ready. Now, this will go over the fish. And I'm not going to... There. Oh! So good. I'm not going to worry about too much of a decoration here, but I would serve the dish thusly. And pass more on the side, of course. A little green belt down the center rather than covering up the salmon. You see, he's really very beautiful as he is. Now, as a garnish, let me show you a quick trick with a lemon and some fresh asparagus. This, I think, is kind of cute. Here we are. We've made little belts out of a lemon. You can see what I've done. You see, you just whittle out the center of the lemon slice and use them as a belt for asparagus.